I just want to encourage you to come out here. That's the best thing you can do for us, and that's why you're becoming a member tonight, is because you show up. You come out here a lot. You've been out here hundreds of times, and we're grateful for it. And when we're laughing, there's nothing wrong in the world. If you're laughing, life is good.
Hi, everybody. I'm Marty Stewart, coming to you from the Ryman Auditorium in Nashville, Tennessee. The Grand Ole Opry is here tonight, the mother church.
I'm so pumped that Gary and I got invited at this very same time. Marty Stewart starts asking us questions about the history of comedy and how, you know, it went from Minnie Pearl and Jerry Clower, and how there's not been a comedian inducted in 50 years, and how comedy's always been part of the Opry. And he said, and we want y'all to be part of the family. And I mean, I fell back, went, no, there's no way. You're not, this ain't happening.
We just don't think we could do without you anymore. And you've been family a long time, and we would like to invite you to be members of the Grand Ole Opry.
No.
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 Are you kidding me?
And I even looked at everybody in the room. I said, is this for real? You know, this ain't funny if y'all are. And it was real.
Oh my God. God.
Oh man.
Oh my God.
Wow. It's mind-boggling. I've never dreamed about this. I never thought this would happen. I never even thought it was in my wheelhouse. So when they invited me, I was basically speechless. You know, I know the staff and a lot of the members, they've been behind me since day one. They're like, oh, you know, we got to get you to be a member. We got to get you to be a member. But I'm like, yeah, whatever. Yeah, okay. I'm just lucky to be here. It hasn't really dawned on me, and I haven't really been able to wrap my head around it. Becoming a member of the Grand Ole Opry, I didn't know how such rarefied air. I mean, the Opry's been around for 97 plus years, and they haven't had a comedian in 50 years. You know, the crazy thing is, I pray it doesn't happen, but if there comes a day when I stop touring because people just kind of stop buying tickets, I've always got a place to come. And they can't keep me off that stage now. It's pretty cool. I'm really not an emotional guy. Even though I don't get choked up, don't get me wrong, this is a huge honor.
Welcome to our family.
I never stand in that circle when I'm performing all those times. I'll walk through it. I don't just stand in there, because I just never thought, I thought, man, you better not catch yourself standing on that thing. So tonight, I'm gonna stand on that circle. That's going to be cool. One thing about the Opry, I've always noticed how the eldership is revered by the younger generation, the younger musicians, and it's the same thing for comedians. I mean, Minnie Pearl, Jerry Clower, I mean, you know, Minnie Pearl came out and said, howdy, you knew what was going on. And Jerry was like, yo! So I got to come up with something.
Subscribe to the Opry YouTube channel to watch new episodes being released each week. Thanks for watching.